Oh, man. Okay, so we're at CMC Cannock. And I am test riding this MT-07 Tracer. They're quite tall. So it's quite a bit taller. I'm sorry I don't get the seat height. Okay, but it feels pretty good. The height's quite intimidating for me though, because it's probably the limit of what I'd like to do for the length of my legs. It's just a little bit too tall. This clutch is so soft. Okay, so this is the Tracer 700. The engine is straight out of the MT-07, and this feels very stable. It's quite nice. Parallel twin. We are recording. Yep. Right. Okay. Parallel twin. Super, super popular with everybody. All types of riders. And I will admit, actually, I did kind of just overlook this when I was shopping for a new bike. I'm totally happy with my 09, but what I will say about the MT-07 is perfect. You wouldn't want any more power or torque than what this has got to offer anyway.
This screen is adjustable with these two knobs.
You've got this little bar here which is ready for a sat nav mount. The bars are quite narrow. The seating position feels nice and natural. Your feet are a little bit further back than your knees, but not that much. So you don't get any modes or anything, or no traction control or anything like that on this on the MT. Just your standard ABS. It does make you feel quite competent. You know, you've got a nice big road presence. Like I feel like with these handguards and those nice big bug eye headlights that it's got, it's you're going to get spotted. People are going to know you're around them. It's roughly around 75 horsepower. But being a parallel twin, that important thing is torque, which at 4,000 revs is very, very apt, very thrilling. And when these get aftermarket pipes on them, oh, they sound sweet. The Tracers come with, I think it's Pilot Road 4, it may be Pilot Road 3, I'm not sure, but it comes with one of those as a standard OEM fit, which makes the turning really nice and steady. Nice predictable roll on the tyre. It does feel a little bit top heavier than what I'm used to, you know, although I've just had like an hour long ride on the MT-09 to get here, but it does feel a little heavier than what I'm used to. This camper van is slightly irritating. So if you're one of the few in the growing market that's becoming more and more interested in bike road trips or holidays on your bike, going overseas, and you're new to biking, or you know, you're not really after that many thrills, you're not wanting to go super fast everywhere, then this is definitely an option for you. personally, it's not exactly what I like from biking. You know, I do like the speed. Sitting on a motorway for hours is not really my cup of tea. But yeah, as I say, that was, you know, that's a, it's a huge growing market in the UK. And then last week when me and the other half went up to the Peak District, I would say there was probably about a 60-40 split of adventure bikes to any other bike, honestly. Added weight of all this top fairing gubbins is does certainly make a difference. You can feel it. It's a little hard for me to differentiate because, you know, like I said, I rode the MT09 of my own down to this test ride, but it's yeah, it's got some pull. It really does pull though. It's just Euro 4, it just strangles these bikes so much. What you do get on this bike is some nice big chunky rubber pegs which stop all the vibration coming through the soles of your boots, which the idea is to stop fatigue and you can travel for longer. It just makes a bit more of a comfortable ride. This would be a great bike for an instructor, actually, thinking about it, or even the 09 Tracer. The bars are quite close to you, you're perfectly upright, you're high up, you can see everything that you need to see.
Very much a utility kind of bike. The back brake hasn't got much bite, but the front is very nice. I am on my tiptoes with this bike. If I was to put both feet down, I am tiptoes, but if I get one foot down, I can get the balls pretty much flat. Pretty much flat foot if I just lean it slightly. A nicely sprung suspension setup on this. It's not bouncy. The rebound's set up right for this bike. And that's because it's set up to be taking panniers and lots of luggage and stuff like that. So it's doing what it should do. You know, I'm quite a big lad, so I'm kind of the equivalent of a normal person plus luggage. And with that extra baggage, it's fueled very, very well. Yeah, the fueling's really good. It doesn't stumble or anything like that. You're not getting that like you normally do in slow moving traffic. Oh dear! What's happened? Whoopsie-daisy, I've got a right hook from the wing mirror. Wing mirror, you know what I mean. So I don't know these roads at all, I've never been down here in my life. And it's run over the bottle. And
yeah, it's doing, I'm doing quite well. The bike's doing well. This is a good road. Slightly thinking about my riding a bit too much to talk at the moment, sorry. But this guy, this TDM is leaving us behind. Hey, this is, I'll tell you what, this is really putting a smile on my face. And like, I sound like I'm surprised, but he's brought us down a great route for this bike. This is so cool, this is fun. It doesn't quite have the punch I remember the old, the standard 07 having. I remember, but that was a Euro 3 model, so I'd say that was ace. I think he's just waited for this guy. We had a new rider behind us. Oh, it's quite tall. It's one course. Let's have a quick walk around, utilize this moment. See, like as always, I have no special agreements with any kind of dealer or anything. It's just test ride days that, you know, demonstrator days that I come out on. This is the MT07 Tracer. Very cool. I like the exhaust. It's new. I think that's a new style for this year. This guy doesn't even own a bike. He's a new rider and he's taking the XSR 900 out. I think he's had a bit of a fright. So all in all, an uneducated review on an MT07 Tracer from a numpty. It's very fun. Very fun. It'll take a pillion well as well. I'll stick up the on the road price now. And this is really good. It's not surprising me in any way, but in a good way. Does that, if that makes any kind of sense? I know what this bike is supposed to do and be capable of, and it is doing it absolutely brilliantly. So stable. Those twisty roads, it had no signs of any kind of movement, twitches, nothing. Get the benefit of a centre stand on these, which is not something that you see all the time now. So little vibration for a twin, a parallel twin. It's smooth as well, the throttle's smooth, there's no vibration. Of course, we need to understand that this is brand new, it has less than 200 miles on it. I'm not going to say it's becoming boring, it's just not got that, for me personally, it's just not got that edge. It does sound a little bit like a lawnmower. This bike is the guy that you have at work, he just gets on with his life,
He doesn't get involved in drama. He doesn't get involved in workplace politics. He just turns up, he does his job, he goes home, and that's it. That's him done.
R.S. Cosworth, that was nice. So I'd like this opportunity to thank CMC Cannock for putting this on. It was completely open to the public, like I said, just said earlier in the video. I have no special arrangements with dealerships or anything. I just turn up, I ask to use their demonstrators.
Some oblige, some don't. And I just use it as an excuse to ride a different bike.
The variety is the spice of life.
See how slow we can go. Well, we're registering zero. Happy with that. Where are you going, brother? Awesome bike. I'd give that a good 7.5 out of 10.